Family of Brianna Cristales and Joshua Williams, welcome and thank you for being here on this important day. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
My wife and I.
You can be seated. We are gathered together to celebrate the very special love between Bree and Josh by joining them in marriage. All of us need and desire to love and be loved. And the highest form of love between two people is within a monogamous, committed relationship. Bree and Josh, your marriage today is the public and legal joining of your souls that have already been united as one in your hearts. Marriage will allow you a new environment to share your lives together, standing together to face life and the world hand in hand. Marriage is going to expand you as individuals, define you as a couple, and deepen your love for one another. To be successful, you will need strength, courage, patience, and a really good sense of humor. So let your marriage be a time of waking each morning and falling in love with each other all over again. Bree and Josh, by coming here today, you have taken the initial step in a wonderful and lasting life together. Understand that a union between two people takes work. Just as Rome wasn't built in a day, neither is a relationship ever complete. It needs constant nurturing. A good marriage is one that fosters respect, a devoted love, and a willingness to make sacrifices for each other. These are the foundation blocks for a newly formed union. Marriage unites you as a couple, yet you are still two separate people with unique ideas, talents, and ways of being. Respect and value those differences, and your relationship will flourish. Joshua and Brianna have written their own vows, which they will now share. Josh.
Alrighty. Just over 6 years ago, we were introduced by a couple of mutual friends. Our relationship began to grow. I got to take this city girl camping and four-wheeling, something she'd never experienced before. Over this weekend of fun, I think we both knew things were going to take off for us. You quickly became my best friend. You've taught me patience, how to love, have given me the greatest gifts a woman can give, our children. As we move forward, I promise to continue to love, respect, protect, cherish our every moments and I'm excited to call you my wife. I love you.
Josh, well, the time has finally come. It's only taken 6 years and two children later. But I can honestly say it was worth the wait. I now fully understand why people say the best things in life come to those who wait. You have been my greatest supporter, my biggest fan, sometimes, the best father to all three of our children, and most of all, my best friend. Thank you for putting up with me on days that I know you wanted to run out that front door. We have been through so much, and I'm glad that we have overcome those obstacles together. Not only have you taught me how to truly love, but you have taught me how to love myself. Now that we are here on our wedding day, sharing our love with our family and friends, I just want to say I am so honored that I will soon be able to call you my husband. You should feel so lucky. Life is all about making choices. We make them every second of every day. Marrying you has got to be one of the easiest choices I've ever made. And today, I choose you to be my partner, my husband, and my person. I love you unconditionally and without hesitation. I vow to love you, encourage you, trust you, and respect you. I vow not to just grow old together, but to grow together. I will love you faithfully through the difficult and easy times. What may come, I will always be there, believing that love never dies. As I have given you my hand to hold, I give you my life to keep. I love you with all my heart.
The ring is a never-ending circle that reminds us of our unending commitment to love one another. And with that in mind, the couple will exchange rings. Josh, as you place the ring on Bree's finger, please repeat after me. I, Joshua, take Brianna to be my wife.
Take Brianna to be my wife.
I promise you love, honor, and respect.
I promise you love, honor, and respect.
To be faithful to you.
Be faithful to you.
And forsaking all others.
And forsaking all others.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
Bree, as you place the ring on Josh's finger, please repeat after me. I, Brianna. Take Josh. To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I promise you love, honor, and respect.
Honor and respect.
To be faithful to you.
To be faithful to you.
And forsaking all others.
And forsaking all others.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
Bree and Josh, you have expressed your love to one another through the commitment and promise you just made. It is with these in mind that I pronounce you husband and wife. You have kissed 1,000 times, maybe more. But today is something different. Today, it's no longer simply a couple or best friends. You have become husband and wife. And now you can seal the agreement with a kiss. Today, your kiss is a promise. You may kiss your bride.
All right.
Face those gathered here. I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Joshua Williams.
No further ado, please put your hands together and give a warm welcome to our newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Joshua Williams. And at this time, we're going to keep our newlyweds on the dance floor for their very first dance as husband and wife.
Strawberry wine. You're as warm as a glass.
and Mrs. Williams, ladies and gentlemen.
Josh, we had our fun, man. Taking our trips, made memories, done a lot. Hello, Miss Holly. We've encouraged each other. We've been there as friends, no matter the distance, no matter what was going on. If something important was going on, we made sure we were there for each other. Bree, you know how I feel about you. I love you. When I first got the ring for my wife, Bree was the first person I showed it to. It was dark, she couldn't really see it, but you know, I shined my cell phone flashlight on it, and you know, she saw it and she was excited. If you take the same passion that we have for our friendship to this marriage, there's no reason it should fail. The most important thing in a marriage is communication. A good way to cut down on some of that communication so that it doesn't hit you all at once is to text and talk throughout the day. Otherwise, when you get home, yap, and you're not gonna have a chance to input anything, all right? Second most important thing is still that communication. Without that communication, things fail. Things fall apart. Trust is lost because expectations are different. If you just keep the communication strong so you guys know what to expect from each other, everything's gonna be great. Love you guys. I'm glad I can make it here. I'm glad y'all invited me. I'm glad y'all entrusted me with this microphone. Let's toast to Josh and Bree Williams.
And bridesmaid Heather this time.
All right, so I'm Heather. I've known Bree the longest, I think, since we were about 12 or 13. And we grew up together. Her parents took us to school. I think we were inseparable in high school. And grew apart, then got back together. And I was there for two of her kids' births, so I'm very lucky for that. And I just want to say I'm really happy for them. I'm really, really happy for Bree. I know how long she wants this, so congrats to you both. And I wish you a lifetime of happiness. Thanks.
I made him honor.
I'm not going to remember all this by heart, so I wrote it down. But hello and good evening to everybody. Hello. For those who don't know me, I'm Mikkel Brina's younger and only sister. We met, of course, when my parents brought me home from the hospital, and she was around the same age as Hallie. So as you can imagine, it was a very traumatic and tragic time. Firstly, I would just like to thank everybody for being here tonight. I know this means so much to them, and they appreciate you sharing this special day with them. They would not be sitting here today if it was not for all the love and support of their family and friends in this room. So thank you. And I'd also like to give a special toast to the parents of the bride and the groom. Thank you for bringing these two together and being loving and supportive grandparents and parents. So, So my fondest memories date back to childhood. Okay. It seems like yesterday we were just talking about our future. Well, the truth is, life took us down totally different paths than we envisioned. Remember when we thought we were going to marry one of the Backstreet Boys? I would say New Kids on the Block, but that would reveal our true age. Bree, I have watched you have a baby when you were almost still a baby. I have watched you laugh, cry, struggle, succeed, love, hurt, and bounce back, and take on all that life has to throw your way. Somehow, some way, you always persevered and moved on, maintaining your optimism. I remember having a conversation with my mom when I was on the phone and living out of state, and she told me that you were going on a date. My response was like, yeah, okay, whatever, we'll see how this goes. To tell you the truth, I wasn't too convinced. When I got the follow-up report, much to my surprise, things went better than expected. So I thought, okay, yeah, we'll see. Now here we are, almost 6 years later with two new beautiful additions to our family. It was anything but conventional, but your family is perfectly imperfect. I have watched both of you grow up and love harder than you've ever loved before. Thank you for giving me three beautiful children to make all of our world complete. I'm so excited to watch you grow and accomplish your dreams and goals in life together. Marriage is about becoming a team. You're going to spend the rest of your life learning about each other. And every now and then, things blow up. But the beauty of marriage is that you picked the right person and you both love each other. You'll always figure out a way to get through it. So please raise your glass with me and cheers to Brianna and Josh. May the darkest day, may the love you feel today feel all of your darkest days.
And best man Aaron.
Salud and happiness.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to apologize in advance for not being a public speaker. If you see me looking down at this piece of paper again and again, it's not actually notes. It's a picture of a massive drink I'm going to have as soon as this is over. People have often commented that Josh and I are like siblings. I suppose I take on the role as the older brother. Wouldn't you agree, little sis? Bree. I was hoping to be the best looking person in the room today, but obviously I failed horribly. You look beautiful. I am so happy for the two of you. May your marriage be filled with laughter and love, and may this be the beginning of a great romance. Josh and Bree have each walked many miles to be here today, and this wedding is a joy to behold. I can speak for everyone in this room when I say we all wish you the happiness that you deserve. And this day is a reminder that the best is yet to come. Congratulations, Josh and Bree. So everyone, raise your glasses high with me and wish these two wonderful souls a continued life of love, magic, and most of all, friendship for the rest of your lives. I love you guys.
As you stand. Tierra Santa. Oigo ese grito de los tambores y los timbales al cumbancha. Ese pregón que canta un hermano que de su tierra vive lejano, que recuerdo le hace llorar. Una canción que vive entonando de su dolor, de su propio llanto, y se le escucha penar.
Suavecito para abajo, para abajo, para abajo. Suavecito para arriba, para arriba. Suavecito para abajo, para abajo. Suavecito para arriba, para arriba.
Sensual,
un movimiento sensual,
sensual.
Un movimiento muy sexy,
sexy.
Un movimiento muy sexy,
sexy.
Y aquí se viene azul azul con este baile que es una bomba. Para bailar esto es una bomba. Para gozar esto es una bomba. Todas las mujeres lo bailan
bomba.
Todos los hombres lo bailan
bomba.
Come on. Swag. Too strong. What's my name?
please put your hands together for Bree and Mother Edgar for their father-daughter dance. Gentlemen, our mother-son dance.
Smash her face into it!
I plan on it.
I'm gonna...
Yeah.
You ain't got a pair of jeans that don't fit just right. There's not a minute in the day that you don't knock me out, you don't blow me away. But girl, now that the sun's gone down, oh, oh, looking at you right here and there.
Wind blowing your